Good morning and welcome to Dronfield Baptist Church. My name is Andy Gore. I am the pastor of this church. And today this is a recording because we have no live stream service. Instead, all the churches of our town, we're gathering together in our civic hall in the town centre. And there we will worship together with our town community, with our council, with representatives from schools and businesses and groups, to remind ourselves that as church we are part and parcel of this lovely town in which we live. We want to bless our town, we want to give thanks to God for our town, we want to pray for our town, and we want to remind ourselves that we are to be salt and light for this town in which we live, that this town may continue to be a wonderful and good place. We're going to sing two songs, Cornerstone and How Deep the Father's Love Is. As we sing these songs remind us of the root of our faith, which means that we do not keep within our church buildings, within our communities. Instead, we are out of the salt cellar, as a famous book once described it, there to be mixing cheek by jowl with all our town, loving it and demonstrating the presence of Jesus. So let us sing together.
Lord, Lord, Lord.
let us come to pray. I want you to think about the town in which you live, if you're not living in Dronfield. Think about the things in which you want to say thank you to Jesus for. Think of the things that make your life joyful there, recognizing that all our towns are always a mix. But what is there that you can say thank you to God for? Please press pause the pastor, and think about your town. We thank you, our loving God, that you are our creator, that you loved us so much you made this world in which we live, in which we may know you are living God. We thank you that in this world we discover your presence in so many ways. We discover your presence in worship as individuals and as a community. We discover your presence in the kindness of people, in their thoughtfulness, their consideration, their love, and in their goodness to us. We thank you that for all people, there are ways in which we can discover and know that you are the God who made them. We thank you that your Son came and he lived an ordinary life, as it were. A carpenter, a child, a son, a brother. And as he was baptized in the Jordan, you, our God, said, "This is my Son with whom I am pleased." And then he went on to make this world in which we live a better place. He declared the coming of the kingdom of God. He changed lives, he healed, he made whole, he set free, he even raised from the dead. And he died and was raised for us, that we may know within our hearts your kingdom, O God, that we may know our lives set free from sin, that we may learn to live his likeness. And we thank you for your Spirit given for us, that our lives may not only be made fuller of you, but that we may be empowered to love and serve you, our God, within our places of work, of play, of home, of our communities we live in, that our communities, O God, may be filled. Our reading is from Matthew 5, verses 13 to 16. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt should lose its taste, how can it be made salty? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled under people's feet. You are the light of the world. A city situated on a hill cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and puts it under a basket, but rather on a lampstand, and it gives light for all who are in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Someone who is new to our church and to our town, they said to me, "Andy, what is the civic service?" Because they were unfamiliar and are unfamiliar with what it is. And so I had to explain to them, it is an opportunity for us, as all the churches in our town, to enable all to know something deeper of the light and the presence of Jesus as we seek to bless and to give thanks for and to pray for the town in which we live. It's also an opportunity, not merely for us as churches, but for people in this town in which we live to know something of the calling, the vocation of God that we have as those made in the image of God, for those of us also who are being remade into the image of Christ, to be those who are light and salt, those who spread salt, who shed light into all the nooks and crannies of our town in which we live. When we moved here 10 years ago, on the day of my induction to this church, We went to St. John's, our parish church, and we experienced for the very first time what a civic service looked like. And it was amazing. It was rammed. It was filled with laughter and joy. And though it was not on the civic territory, rather churches, yet it showed so much of the good that a civic service can do in reminding and blessing this town in which we live with God. Jesus, in the Sermon on the Mount, he describes who we are as those who belong to him. But he also speaks very deeply of how we are to live as this people of God who seek to follow in his steps, and of how knowing him must affect the world of work, the world of rest, the world of play. It's not merely something that we do or are in a building. It's something that is a 24/7 thing. Jesus, in the Beatitudes, the first 12 verses of the Sermon on the Mount, he has described the difference knowing him makes within our lives. He describes his impact, his transformative power upon those who are blessed, those who follow him. Thus, we are those who, like, poor in spirit. We are those who mourn, who grieve the wrong in the world. We are those who are meek, those who are humble. We hunger and we thirst for the right things, for righteousness, for justice. We are those who are merciful. We are those who seek to make peace. We are those who know trouble because people don't always like maybe what we say or do. Not because we do it wrongly, because it shows up the wrong maybe within their lives. And this is something of what Jesus means for us to be salt and light. We are salt and light because Jesus is at work in us. And because he's at work in us, so our lives radiate something of his difference in who we are. Jesus savors us. He makes us a winsome people, but also through us floods the light and glory of his love and of his presence. To be salt and light isn't something that we work up within ourselves, but instead something that we learn to be like as we learn to reflect more of God's goodness, his presence, his glory, his love in our lives day by day. As we know the work of the Spirit within us, his transforming work in us, so not merely should others see this difference, but others' lives should be themselves blessed by us because God is at work in us and through us. And to be salt and light is not an option. It's not something that is an extra to our lives that we may or may not choose to do. It is part of who we are to be. It is a must in the sense of, it's not a must in the sense of me pleading with you, please be salt, please be light. Instead, it is our privilege and our joy that through each and every one of us, Jesus invites us to live his life out. He enriches us by saying, join with me in who I am as one through whom the presence of God is known. That's why I love doing what I do within the schools in the town, the three schools I participate in. I love to do this. I go into these schools that I may demonstrate something of the love and the glory, the presence of Jesus. It's why I love being part of Dronfield Together, this hub group, because I want all those people who are connected to this group to be blessed, to be encouraged in all the good that they do. It's why I love playing and being part of our ukulele group, because we do not merely play our ukulele here in church. We want to get out into our community. We go into one of the care homes, and there we play that we may bless those who are there who are frail, but also profoundly ill with dementia. We go into schools. We go into other community spaces. That as we play the silly songs, and they are silly songs, so we may bring a smile to people's hearts and minds. That's why we do it. We want this place to be a happier and better place. And may this be true for all of us. I know I am privileged, I have the opportunity, but whatever opportunities that you have, may you make the most of them at work, at rest, at play, that in all of your life, you may show Jesus, that you may be like salt that brings this savoring touch, that you may be like light that floods wherever you are, wherever you go, with the presence and joy of Jesus. Jesus said, you are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. May we embrace this vocation. May we live it out in our lives, that the places in which we live will be enriched by them. Let's come together and let's pray together. We pray, our loving God, for the places in which we work, the places in which we rest, the places in which we play. We pray for them that they will be places which are made better because of us in all who we are. We pray that we may be salt, that we may be light. We pray for your worldwide church in all its differing locations, in its different ways. Help them, we pray, our God, to live out being salt and light wherever they are. In so many different situations compared to our own, may you strengthen and bless and enable them, O God, we pray. So come upon us, O Spirit. Equip us, enable us, embolden us to be salt, to be light to the towns in which we live. Amen. We conclude this short act of worship by singing, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder. It reminds us of our salvation, but of our God as a creator God, who calls us to be his image, his likeness in this world in which we live.
My soul, my Savior, come to thee. bread I think, that God's Son was praying, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. There sits my soul, my Savior, bow to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. There sits my soul, my Savior, bow to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come, with shouts of acclamation, and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then shall I
bless you as we conclude our worship. May the love of Jesus sustain you. May the joy of Jesus fill you. May the power of Jesus strengthen you to be his salt, his light in the world in which we live, in the town in which you live, for his sake and his glory. Amen. Next week, we're back to being live stream. It is a harvest service. Paul Grime from Christian Aid is speaking for us. So come and join in either live or by this recording. And may you know his blessing afresh. Hope to see you next week. Thank you and goodbye.